Tantor Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Blackthorn's Botanical Magic, The Green Witch's Guide to Essential Oils for Spellcraft, Ritual, and Healing, by Amy Blackthorn. Narrated by Romy Nordlinger. There is virtually no people known to anthropology, however remote, isolated, or primitive, which did not practice some form of doctoring with plants. These healing plants exert a beneficial effect on every important part of the body, and may have been carefully chosen to fortify man in his journey to another world. Barbara Griggs, Green Pharmacy. This book contains advice and information relating to herbs and is not meant to diagnose, treat, or prescribe. It should be used to supplement, not replace the advice of your physician or other trained healthcare practitioner. If you know or suspect you have a medical condition, are experiencing physical symptoms, or if you feel unwell, seek your physician's advice before embarking on any medical program or treatment. Listeners using the information in this book do so entirely at their own risk, and the author and publisher accept no liability if adverse effects are caused. Caution is advised on the potentially harmful side effects some essential oils may pose to pets. Introduction. No magic wand needed. Smell. That's right. Go ahead, take a deep breath. Oh, wait. If you're breathing, you are alive. And if you can smell, then you can enhance that life you're busy trying to live, no matter who you are. This journey is yours for the taking. No magic wand needed. Aromatherapy and magic. One-stop shopping. Our sense of smell is the greatest sense, and even older than our sight. I'm Amy Blackthorn, witch, herbalist, martial artist, photographer, and your guide to the world of botanical magic. Why botanical magic, you ask? Because by using our sense of smell, we can change our outlook, our mood, and even our dreams. What dreams would you like to fulfill? People have been working with plants longer than we have had language. Whether or not you call yourself a witch, whether you have just purchased your first bottle of essential oil or the local shop has you on speed dial, there is something in this book for you. Before I get ahead of myself, though, let's make sure we're all on the same page. What is this magic stuff anyway? Rabbits and hats? No, my dear. Magic is agency. Magic is the ability to demand better from the universe because you damned well deserve it. Say it out loud. Who cares who hears you? Magic is the ability to take all the feelings you have inside and turn them into something greater than the sum of their parts. Do you want to banish womanizers? Do it. Do you want to take back your power? Do it. Do you want to reach far-off places or just make sure you keep a roof over your head? Do it. Magic can give you the sense of control you have wanted your entire life, no matter where or how you were raised. While we are forever colored by the things we have experienced, those things don't have to define who we are now if we don't want them to. The only person in control of the narrative of your life is you. Magic gives you the agency not just to change the story, but to scrap the whole thing and start over if you want. Decide from moment one that you have taken control of your story, and you have. Magic is just the tool to help it along. You are the one holding the key. No magic wand needed. I'm frequently asked how long I've been doing this magic stuff. My first instinct is to reply, "How do you define magic?" For me, gardening is magic. Think about it. Specks of dust go into the ground, and beautiful things emerge from it. My first foray into gardening involved me helping neighbors and being paid in handfuls of loose change. I saved every bit of it, because more than anything, I wanted plants of my very own. I bought a green plastic window box and a bag of good soil that I lugged home on my bike without the luxury of a basket. I've filled that window box with 6 packs of petunias, specifically Dream's Midnight Petunias. That was magic right there. Boy, howdy. Those flowers were a shade of purple so dark that the center of each one was black, and they smelled like the leading edge of a summer thunderstorm over a raging ocean. Magic was taking care of those fragile-looking stems and being rewarded with flowers that looked like velvet umbrellas filled with song. In high school, I chose to pursue a 2-year botany and floriculture program instead of a traditional school experience. I had never been happier. I was already studying witchcraft by that point, and my love of herbalism, growing plants, and horticulture never faded. My independent study project was to grow all the herbs I wanted all year. I bartered with the culinary students, trading herbs for free food. What high schooler would turn down real food? And built up my own personal stores of herbs. I perfected my potions. The popular girls who would never admit to being curious about what I did came to me for the secrets of my clear skin and pleasant outlook. For you, dear reader, my secret was weekly steam facials with rosemary and calendula. The secret to magic is stillness, being able to block out distractions and letting go once the magic is in motion. Spells are directing the energies where we need them to go through many methods: candles, singing, dancing, and more. In our society, we teach magic to children before they know their own names. We practice nearly worldwide sympathetic magic at least once a year. Don't believe me? Think back to children's birthday parties. On their first birthday, before a child knows what a candle is, they're taught candle magic. Your nearest and dearest disappear, and candles appear. The birthday song is sung, raising energy and setting the intention. The birthday boy or girl closes their eyes and makes a wish. They blow out the candle, cementing the intention. And then comes everyone's favorite part, cake. Cake is scientifically proven to cause happiness. Eating after spell work also happens to be the quick and easy way to ground excess energy. Process for candle magic. 1. Decide on a goal. One popular example would be money. 2. Visualize the end result. Maybe you need $42 to pay a parking ticket. 3. Focus your intent to manifest that end result. There are lots of ways to focus that intent. Maybe it's with a money chant. For example, I use the OJ song, "For the Love of Money." Money, 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 money. 4. Light the candle. 5. Set it and forget it. Wait. That's an infomercial. Forget I said that. Seriously, though, if you obsess about the working, you're undoing all that hard work. Let the magic do its job. Bonus tip. Make sure the candle you are using is virgin. Don't use a candle that has already been used for another purpose, or you'll muddy the magic. One intention per candle only. What is one of the few events that is celebrated nearly everywhere on the planet? New Year's Eve. And all over the world, people celebrate in their own way. Tidying their homes, stocking larders and kitchens, spending time with friends and loved ones, counting down to midnight. What happens when the time comes? Kissing, cheering, hugging, joyous noise. Champagne toasts are traditional as well. Why? We are using sympathetic magic in an attempt to sweeten the year ahead. Sympathetic magic involves using symbols associated with an event or person to be influenced. On New Year's Day, traditional foods are prepared to bring prosperity, sweetness, a hailful home, and loving family and friends. By making sure we enter the new year in a good way, we are performing a ritual action to affect the rest of the year. People are doing magic all the time. They just never stop to think about it. The day I moved into my first home, my mother spent a good deal of time lecturing me on how to move in. There were rules I had never known, because though I'd moved a lot as a child, I'd never been in charge of the moving. After painting and cleaning, the house gets cleansed. Magical cleansing involves energetic cleaning as well as physical. For more on this, see Chapter 1, Cleansing Smoke and Clearing Energies. Then the home is blessed. Before any boxes are allowed to move into the new home, there is a procession, a loaf of bread so the occupants are always fed, a bottle of wine so there is always drink, a jar of salt so there is always prosperity, and a new broom so as not to bring old issues from the last house into the new one. These sympathetic magical tools help ensure a happy and healthy home. Magic is alive and well in our culture, but no one calls it that. It's just what we do. So why essential oils? Simply put, essential oils are the soul of the plant, distilled into its finest point. You can't get the soul of a plant from a synthetic. Fragrance oils can smell nice, but smelling nice is not the soul of a plant. It is not the magic. It's just something that smells nice. Botanical magic is different from what you might think it is. Yes, spells, magic, and witchcraft have a reputation for needing a lot of accoutrement, certainly. However, with botanical magic, you are going right to the source. You are tapping directly into the realm of magic, into the heartbeat of the earth, and creating a change for yourself, change that you control. That change can be utilized by anyone, yogis, therapists, witches, accountants, nurses, just by adding your will, desire, and energy. The magic ingredient is you. Without you, these are just oils. You can use plant material in spell work rather than the essential oil, just as you can use a single note rather than a whole song. But just as a single note will never be the same as Led Zeppelin's Ramble On, a single bud cannot hope to compare to a bottle of lavender essential oil. You can do anything. It's the botanicals that lend that extra connection to the world. You know that place outside where it's too bright to see your phone screen, and there's weather. I'm hoping I can push you outside your comfort zone on this one. The plants are out there waiting for us to remember them. 1. Cleansing Smoke and Clearing Energies. Regular use of cleansing smoke with a variety of materials is beneficial to an energetically healthy home. Too many folks rely solely on one cleaning method and one protection method. For example, many people enjoy the way white sage, Salvia apiana, smells, and though it is a good ally for clearing and cleansing space, it should not be your only ally. Just as folklore says to turn your garments inside out if you think you've been bewitched, so too should your home's energy change. Changing the energetic signature of you, your home, and your loved ones makes it harder for anything nasty to recognize you. True curses and hexes are much rarer than one might be led to believe. They take training, dedication, and effort. That being said, jealousy has a power all its own, and it does not need training, materials, or much effort. Only the green-eyed monster. The resentment that jealousy harbors can lead to bad luck, accidents, and worse. You will find many options for protections, cleansings, and the like throughout this book. See the recipe index for a full list. Sage is the go-to for many people, but you don't want to build the magical equivalent of a medically resistant staph infection. Change up your cleansing lineup on a regular basis. Maybe use Florida water 1 month, anise protection incense the next, and then sweet grass. Anthoxanthum nightens, after that. Then try burning frankincense. This is also beneficial in the case of witch wars and grudges. If friend X is no longer welcome in your home and they are likely to try bane work, having a varied protection routine makes it harder for someone to anticipate your plan of action and counter it. Smoke tools. There is a hierarchy of smoke tools related to their efficacy. The weakest of the smoke tools is floral smoke. Lavender buds, for example, are very pleasant-smelling. Flowers are well-suited to brightening a space. Leaves are slightly stronger and are good for refreshing the energy of a space. White sage is a common example. Since white sage is largely wildcrafted, harvested in the wild, and used by native peoples, the increasing use of herbal cleansing smoke has led to skyrocketing prices and difficulty in sourcing the materials for the native peoples to whom white sage is sacred. The salvia genus has many allies that can be farmed and don't infringe on the beliefs and practices of First Nations and Native American people. There are many herbs found in this book that work just as magically. The roots of a plant are stronger magically than its leaves. Roots will remove energies and entities that were not bothered by leaf smoke. Consider the strength of plant allies like ginger root, calamus root, and galangal root, lojon. Even stronger than the root allies are wood allies. Palo Santo is a popular wood-based smoke tool. This tree, native to Peru and the Yucatan Peninsula, has become increasingly popular in the last few years. This author even spotted it in a chain store that sells costumes, shot glasses, and t-shirts at the local mall. Because of the popularity of this wood, the trees that take decades to reach maturity are over-harvested. The strongest smoke tool of the plant ally families is the resin group. Tree resins are hardened sap structures like dragon's blood, Dracaena draco, frankincense, Boswellia carteri, copal, protium copal, and myrrh. Camphora myrrha. If there is a problem that has not been affected by the lower energy signatures of the plant allies, a resin should do the trick. Dragon's blood. This popular incense resin, resembling red chalk, commonly comes from two species, Dracaena draco and Dracaena cinnabari, though there are more than the two varieties of Dracaena that produce this fragrant resin. Many assume that all dragon's blood is Dracaena draco. Both produce a similarly colored sap, with musky warm notes with a hint of floral, though D. cinnabari has a touch more of the floral note than its cousin D. draco. D. cinnabari is the slower growing of the two varieties, though both trees take over 10 years to produce their signature red sap. Due to over-harvesting and habitat loss, both species of Dracaena are on the threatened list. Note. While no essential oil of dragon's blood exists at this time, high-quality dragon's blood oils can be sourced in Appendix D, Botanical Magic Resources. 2. Timing the work. The timing of a magical working can make the difference in fighting against the tide and your magic making it to shore. Rather than putting extra effort to work against the moon or the day of the week, try rewording the working. Color magic. Essential oils are used in anointing oil blends, and candles are frequently anointed in botanical magic. Here's a cheat sheet of what all the different colored candles signify. Red, passion, fertility, enthusiasm, conquering fear, bravery, fast action. Magenta, fuel for immediate action, enhances other colors. Add speed to magic. Pink. Gentle romance, friendship, honor, harmony, heart relationships, family. Peach. Quiet emotions of joy, strength, peace, truth. Orange. Adaptability, success, encouragement, uplifting, thoughtful. Yellow. Success, thought, will, intent. Green. Prosperity. Fast money, healing past lives. Use with brown for stable financial resources. Blue, spiritual and physical healing, wisdom, balance, trust, tranquility. Purple, intuition, the divine, guidance, power, ambition, prophetic dreams. Black, banishing, hex breaking, breaking bad habits. White, spiritual enlightenment, cancel magical aims, stalemate, Purity, neutral, all-purpose, serenity. Brown, stability, material wealth, physical goods, real estate, decision-making, emotional balance, professional growth. Gray, neutrality, can be used to cause confusion in an enemy if hexes are directed your way. Self-defense, neutralizing harmful energies. Gold, the god, fast luck, success, intelligence, solar influence. Silver, the goddess, resolve inner conflict, persistence, remove negativity. Days of the week. Here are the best days of the week to perform each type of magic. Sunday, personal empowerment, success, generosity, luck. Monday, spirituality, virtue, emotional security, and well-being. Tuesday, drive, confidence, ambition, victory, vitality. Wednesday, knowledge, change, charm, communication. Thursday, luck, power, protected growth, accomplishment, money, honor. Friday, beauty, grace, the arts, love, fertility, bonding, sex appeal. Saturday, the law, loss, endings, transforming, banishings, interrupting. Moon phases and magic. To give your magic a boost, try timing it with a phase of the moon. For things that won't wait, go with the day of the week that works best. Waxing moon, growing toward full. Do magic for increase, prosperity, health, wellness, love. Full moon, alignment of moon, earth, and sun, sometime resulting in an eclipse. All-purpose, use the extra boost for the metaphysical heavy lifting, court cases, protection. Waning moon, shrinking toward the new moon. Practice magic of decrease, bringing things to a close, removing bad habits, negative people, debt, illness. New moon, first light, new growth, beginning projects, set ideas in motion, set goals for the month. Dark moon, the absence of light. Do magic surrounding intuition, turning inward, cleansing, banishing or binding both people and addictions. Blue moon, the second full moon in a calendar month. Do magic for wishes. Black moon, the second new moon in a calendar month. Do magic for serious binding, banishing, stalkers, serious illness, addiction, heavy lifting. Identifying moon phases just by looking. You may have seen a triple moon symbol. It's not just a clever design. This is the waxing full and waning moon depicted. So if you look up into the sky and the moon is pointing to the left, it is waxing. If it is pointing to the right, it is waning. 3. Making oils magical. To perform botanical magic, it's not necessary to memorize a bunch of recipes and formulas. Instead, my goal is to help you learn the basics and then piece together blends for yourself to suit what you have on hand and what's happening at that moment. Eventually, you'll be able to stretch your wings and create your own blends. Essential oils. Essential oils are present in more products than they are given credit for, and now with internet-based retailers, boutique aromatherapy shops, and artisanal essential oils from farms, there is a surge in interest in the benefits of aromatherapy in everyday life. This includes magical practitioners. Knowing how these essential oils are derived is important, as it can affect the product's scent, whether you can apply it to your skin, and how much it costs. Caveat emptor. Experiment with different brands of essential oils whenever possible. Do not assume that just because an oil is more expensive, that means it's more potent. An ethical company will clearly print on the label when they have diluted an oil, which is common for more rare or expensive oils. Commonly diluted oils include frankincense, blue chamomile, jasmine, melissa, also known as lemon balm, myrrh, neroli, and rose. Unscrupulous companies dilute other oils for their profit, so get to know the oils you want to use. For example, vetiver oil is dark and syrupy, so if the oil is clear and fluid, then either it's been diluted or it's not actually vetiver. See Appendix C, testing your essential oils for quality and purity for methods of testing oil integrity at home with common household goods. Let's go over some of the ways these oils are produced. Extracting essential oils. Essential oils are single plants broken down into their volatile constituents through distillation, solvents, or expression. Steam distillation. Steam distillation is the most common method of essential oil extraction and is used mostly for leaves and herbs. Here's how it works. Steam is forced up through a container of plant material into a condenser coil. The steam then collects and travels down the coil and drips into a specialized collection container. The liquid oil is lighter than water, so it rises to the top and drains off. The water left behind is referred to as a hydrosol. Hydrosols. Hydrosols are the byproducts of steam distillation that contain 0.02 to 0.03% dissolved particles of the essential oil that was created. They are scented naturally by the plant material they derive from. However, do not expect the hydrosol to smell exactly like its essential oil counterpart due to the much smaller ratio of dissolved plant material inherent in the solution. Magically speaking, hydrosols have the same properties as the plant's essential oil at a lower price. Until recently, many companies simply disposed of this beautiful water as a byproduct of the oil-making process. But hydrosols are valuable topical products in their own right. For example, one could use a lavender hydrosol as a spritz to call on the protective energies of lavender without needing to acquire and mix lavender essential oil, an oil carrier, and mixing equipment. Hydrosols are excellent bases for liquid smudge blends. They are gentle on the skin and can safely be added to the bath when an essential oil may be irritating. Many hydrosols are simply sold in pump bottles, as they make a nourishing mist for skin, fresh from the refrigerator on a hot day, or from the gym bag before you jump into the car to head home, and are sold as yoga mat sprays to freshen yoga mats after a vigorous practice. Anytime a blend mentions water diffusers, it is possible to use a water-based room spray, or hydrosol, if a diffuser is impractical. Place 1 teaspoon table salt or witch hazel in a glass bowl and add 30 drops essential oil or synergy. Top with 2 tablespoons water and stir well. Transfer the synergy into a spray bottle and fill with warm water. Give it a good shake before spraying. Note, if essential oils are placed directly into water for spraying, they can leave oil stains on surfaces, so always use an intermediary. Water distillation. Water distillation is used for flowers that are too delicate for steam distillation. Water distillation can be accomplished at home with few materials and makes beautiful waters that can be used in magic, cosmetics, and aromatherapy. Solvent extraction. Solvents are used to extract oils from delicate plant materials, namely flowers. The oil extracted with the solvent method is referred to as an absolute, such as rose absolute. Keep in mind the amount of time as well as the sheer quantity of flowers it takes to produce this material when looking at the price. For example, it takes about 60 roses to produce just 1 drop of rose absolute. Expression, cold pressing. Cold-pressed oils are a bit of a misnomer. The room temperature materials, citrus peels are the most common cold-pressed essential oils, are crushed between large rollers to release a dark-colored and highly fragrant oil. Synergies. A blend of two or more essential oils is known as a synergy. Synergies have a number of applications for our use. Ritual synergies can fill a room with a protective scent via a diffuser. Keep in mind that synergies have not been diluted, so they may be dangerous to put directly onto the skin. They are meant to be used in nasal inhalation tubes, room diffusers, or oil burners. Caution! Please do not put undiluted essential oils on your skin without the direction of a certified aromatherapist. These are volatile oils and can cause chemical burns if caution is not used. Please seek the advice of a certified aromatherapist before using essential oils on anyone under 12, and never use essential oils on infants. They simply do not have the body mass and will reach toxic levels very quickly. Although some vendors of essential oils are simultaneously trained professional aromatherapists, many, if not most, are not. Please be sure to consult with someone who has properly accredited training. Schools that train accredited aromatherapists will have listings that can be searched. Base and carrier oils. The term base oil and carrier oil mean the same thing in terms of essential oils, and I use them interchangeably. Base oils can enhance the effect of your magic. The majority of base or carrier oils come from seeds or nuts. This is important for magic because the energy of new life contained within those oils can bring a powerful push of creation to any spell you use them in. When choosing a carrier oil, consider the situation or occasion, the oil's shelf life, and your personal preference. For example, if an oil is being designed for a sabbat, choosing a carrier oil with a shelf life of 3 months means that a very small amount should be blended. Conversely, if the oil being designed is for a sabbat ritual attended by 300 people, using an oil with a short shelf life is perfectly understandable because many people will use the oil that day and there will be very little remaining. When creating an oil for your purposes, putting an expiration date on your label can save you time and energy. Properly cared for, your oil could last beyond the stated times. Trust your nose. You will know a rancid oil when you smell one. Proper care of oil blends includes dark glass or dark number 1 plastic polyethylene terephthalate, PET bottles, stored away from oil-destroying UV rays. A stable temperature is helpful, especially one on the cool side. Heat can be as detrimental as UV exposure. Oils with a short shelf life can be stored in the refrigerator to help lengthen their lifespan. Remember, even if they are kept out of light, oils are still susceptible to oxidation. This means that the longer the oil has been in the bottle and the more oil has been used, the more space in the bottle that contains oxygen that can corrupt the oil inside. Extending the shelf life of oils. When creating oil blends, orifice reducers are important, not only to lessen the chance of a costly oil spill, but because the reducer will help keep your oils fresher longer. Adding a preservative to your oils can extend shelf life as well. Vitamin E capsules are a popular additive to combat oxidation, as is tincture of benzoin. To make tincture of benzoin, mix 1/4 teaspoon ground or powdered benzoin and 1/4 cup 100-proof vodka. Shake vigorously and let steep for 6 weeks. Vitamin E is a good preservative for massage oils. Add 10 drops vitamin E per 8 fluid ounces of carrier oil or 5 drops of benzoin tincture per ounce of carrier oil. Following are a few recommended carrier oils. Apricot kernel oil. Apricot kernel oil has a nourishing effect on the skin, and its nutrients are easily absorbed. The penetrating action of the oil will deliver whatever has been added to it down into the deeper layers of skin, the subcutaneous tissue. It is well suited for sensitive or aging skin. The benefit for magical practitioners is this oil becomes a part of you, rather than sitting on the surface of the skin with a greasy feel. The oil becomes part of the practitioner, a fitting visual for oils dedicated to certain deities and their dedicants. Apricot kernel oil is useful for anything related to Venus. Love, the arts, beauty, luxury. It also works well in blends designed to facilitate a good night's sleep. Apricot kernel oil's shelf life is 6 to 12 months. Avocado oil. On the skin, this oil is very penetrating and much heavier than apricot kernel oil. Cold-pressed avocado oil has incredible fats that make for a rich moisturizer for all skin types. It can help clear problem skin and has anti-inflammatory properties. It contains vitamin E and other antioxidants. Avocado oil is magical by itself, and that magic involves creating new life and new beginnings as well as prosperity. That is just the energy of new life waiting to burst out of the seed. Because avocado has that round, full seed, it is useful in magic for fertility, including ritual oils for procreation, increasing sex drive in a partner, and lust. It's not just for physical fertility, mind you. If you need to make your business fertile, using an avocado-based oil is the way to go. The oil of avocado has a relatively short shelf life, so make small batches or only what will be used immediately. Use within 3 months. Coconut oil. Fractionated and expressed coconut oils are equally nourishing for the skin. The largest difference between the two is their room temperature states. Fractionated coconut is liquid at room temperature, while expressed coconut oil is solid with a low melting point. Many companies dilute their most expensive essential oils with jojoba or fractionated coconut oil to lessen the impact on the wallet. Coconut oil is a neutral-smelling body and cooking oil, and it is easy to find on the shelf in the grocery store. Additionally, it is easy to find organic coconut oil at reasonable prices. Coconut oils are well-suited to blends involving love, lunar magic, abundance, balance, childbirth or conception, good luck, or elemental magic. The stability or shelf life of coconut oil is 2 or more years. Evening primrose oil. Evening primrose is a very gentle, very light oil that is easily absorbed into the skin. It makes an empowering facial moisturizer, especially well-suited to the delicate skin around the eyes. Evening primrose oil is highly regarded for its anti-inflammatory properties. Studies have suggested that it even has the ability to help children with hyperactive disorders and adults with autoimmune-related fatigue. As always, discuss with your doctor before beginning any treatment, even with over-the-counter remedies. Using evening primrose oil in a magical practice has a long history. This oil is popular across many genres and is thick enough that it is even sold as a drain opener. The plant's usefulness for wound healing means that it is connected magically with protection, boundaries, and sustaining luck. The evening portion of its name comes from the night-blooming properties of this plant, which are associated with intuition, psychic ability, and increasing vision. Evening primrose can be used to create egg shielding around your person. Creating an egg shield. The visual of an egg is a popular one for establishing a protective shield around an individual. It is easy to erect and maintain an egg shield, and its blank canvas allows for later additions, such as sigils, magical symbols that translate to ideas. For a beginning practitioner, the idea is to spend time at first sitting quietly and picturing yourself surrounded by a strong, thick shell of an egg. New practitioners have come back asking why their shielding isn't working, only to find that they have left holes in the shield for various reasons. That defeats the purpose. So we use the visual of the eggshell. See that shell protecting you. Envision as much detail as possible. Once the details are set, practice setting it faster and faster in subsequent sessions until you can have it in place faster than you can blink. Remember, practice makes perfect. Some people put their shielding in place before leaving their home, just like putting on a jacket or sunglasses. Let your shielding protect you from magical threats as well as help you move through the mundane world. Massaging the oil into the skin around the eyes before meditation, journeying, and channeling can help inner sight. For sufferers of night terrors, the light texture of this oil will lend itself to magical perfumes well. See the anise section for additional suggestions on combating night terrors. Since evening primrose oil's shelf life is so short, it is ideal for long-term magical projects that are undertaken daily for 1 to 3 months. For example, creating a perfume blend for a devotional deity and applying it during prayer every day for 90 days. The shelf life of evening primrose oil is 3 to 6 months. Grapeseed oil. Grapeseed oil has an ideal viscosity for skin applications. It has been known to hydrate skin, reduce wrinkles, and diminish the appearance of scars. It also has mild astringent properties, so it is useful for teenage skin or problem areas. Since grapeseed is exceedingly good for skin balancing, why not use the oil for affirmations in magical practice? Anoint the tips of the fingers and massage into skin, repeating affirmations for the day. I am worthy of love. I am prosperous. I am safe and whole. Grapeseed's texture makes it an ideal anointing oil for oneself or deity statues. Always patch test on an inconspicuous spot if you choose to use an oil on any painted or stained surface. It is neutral and will not influence essential oils one way or another, so it is a good all-purpose oil for love potions and more. The long history of grapes and early civilizations makes it an ideal oil with which to announce your intent to the gods for a number of different goals. It's also affordable and easy to find in many grocery stores, making it a popular carrier for beginning oil enthusiasts and seasoned connoisseurs alike. The shelf life of grapeseed oil is 4 to 6 months. Jojoba oil. Jojoba is referred to as an oil because of its viscosity, but it is not actually an oil at all. Jojoba is a vegetable wax that is liquid at room temperature. Highly moisturizing and good for all skin types, jojoba is penetrating and filled with antioxidants. It also has naturally occurring fungicidal properties, and so is beneficial for nail beds and feet. Because jojoba is found in the desert, this interesting plant is used in magic involving perseverance. If something absolutely has to get done, jojoba is definitely the oil to go for overcoming obstacles. Jojoba is used for overcoming the insurmountable and will not give up. It's also useful for oils based in self-confidence, as it is used to banish doubt. This oil also banishes melancholy. Jojoba has a long shelf life, and though blends should be used within a year, it is not uncommon to see oil blends much older that have not yet gone rancid. Stability for jojoba is 1 to 2 years, depending on treatment. Mineral oil. Mineral oil is a petroleum distillate. The World Health Organization classified untreated mineral oil as a Group 1 carcinogen, and it has been used to kill aphids and other pests. It is not recommended for use on skin. Used in magic, this mineral oil is effective for any blend that involves minerals, especially if the recipe calls for things like sulfur or lodestone. Even before other oils can be added, mineral oil is beneficial for prosperity oils. Mineral oil is good for oils of a compelling nature. Getting someone to do something you need, such as the popular hoodoo oils like Boss Fix, Just Judge, and Bend Over oils. A recipe well-suited to mineral oil would be binding bending. For more information, check out BlackthornHoodooBlends.com. If you need something done right now, reach for mineral oil. It has been used by fire performers the world over, so use it for rapid change of circumstance. Because mineral oil is not natural oil, but rather a byproduct of gasoline production, it does not become rancid the way food or seed-based oils do. If left for too long, however, mineral oil starts to gel, just as gasoline does. This gelatin-like consistency does not harm the efficacy of the oil, but with the prevalence of the oil and the inexpensive nature of it, it is best to simply replace it. Olive oil. Olive oil can have a very strong smell, especially if you are not grabbing the more refined olive oils. Olive's soothing properties make it a boon in the bathroom as well as in the kitchen. Olive can help heal dry, cracked skin as well as skin with inflammatory problems. During the winter, keep a small bottle in the bathroom cabinet to massage into hands directly after a shower to lock in moisture. This easy-to-use oil is usually on hand. When olive oil is used by itself, the effect of your magic is for blessings. It is sacred to a number of religious traditions, so it makes a good anointing oil. Olive oil is perfect for prosperity, as well as anything for good health. If you need hard and fast money right now, reach for this. If the goal of a spell has to do with tangible property, olive is the way to go. Olive is the friend of prosperity oils, but think buying a house, not I need $20 before payday. Folklore says that if a rich spouse is desired, olive is the oil to reach for. Stability or shelf life is 9 to 12 months. Sunflower oil. Sunflower is useful because of its affiliation with the sun. This is not just because it looks like the sun. This flower's big, fiery orange-yellow brightness attracts all eyes in the meadow. The sunflower is the quickest producer of any oils. What does that mean for magic? Prosperity. If you need quick cash, reach for the sunflower oil. If you need oil for the absolute best results, where failure is not an option, grab that sunflower oil. This oil is protected growth. For long-term goals, a year, 5 years, or 10 years, you want to nurture that growth very slowly, and sunflower oil will shine its light upon you. Sunflower turns light into tangible food sources. The shelf life for sunflower oil is 12 months. Sweet almond oil. Sweet almond oil is commonly used in cosmetics and as a carrier oil in many different applications. It is very gentle on the skin and has a light texture. This oil is a good choice for massage oils, as it is not quickly absorbed, and anointing oils. Sweet almond is a nice alternative to the heavy feeling of olive oil. In magic, the oil is useful for prosperity work. It is beneficial for asking the blessings of nature spirits, such as the fae or devas. The energy of sweet almond is that unconditional positive regard. Magically, it is a gentle oil and will work forgivingly. It is an all-purpose oil that is well-suited for protection spells, especially spells involving children and their innocence. It has been used in love spells for that gentle, innocent first love. The shelf stability of sweet almond oil is 9 to 12 months. Recommended dilution. Here are some general rules of thumb for when you're mixing an essential oil with a carrier oil. 1% dilution or less. Delicate skin areas around the eyes and face. Oils that are safe to use during pregnancy. 1.5% dilution. Emotional aromatherapy. Energy work. 2.5% dilution, massage therapy, general aromatherapy, skin care for thicker skin, elbows, feet. The recipes in this book are calculated for 2.5% for skin safety and 0.5% with sensitizing oils like cinnamon. There are websites and smartphone apps that include dilution calculators. Above 2.5% is not recommended for magical aromatherapy. Discuss with a certified aromatherapist, massage therapist, or naturopath before using. Infused oils. Infused oils are made by placing herbal material into the chosen carrier oil and allowing the oil to take on the properties of the plant material over time. Let the mixture sit in a dark corner cabinet or on a shelf in a warm room for a few weeks. The oil will take on the properties of the plant material. Infused oils are much less fragrant than essential oils, but can be used effectively in magic and may be significantly more cost-effective. Tips for crafting infused oils. Dried material is always used to prevent molding. The key to infused oils is patience. With harder, woody plant material, the infused oil may not be ready to use for 6 to 8 weeks. If you are making an oil for a special occasion, make sure to leave plenty of time. The benefit of making your own infused oils is that you can use plant materials that are rare, that are not available in essential oil form, or that are too sensitizing for cosmetic use, but may be suitable for magical use. Plants that have no cosmetic or holistic usefulness can be infused to use year-round. The oils that are locked in the plant material will then be absorbed into the fatty oils of the carrier that is being used. Many cooking oils employ this technique. For example, olive oil infused with Chinese hot peppers is frequently available at the grocery store. It carries properties of the Chinese hot pepper and is similarly useful for banishing spells. This technique is also beneficial for plants that in essential oil form would be ill-suited, too sensitizing for use on skin, or irritating in ritual baths. A practitioner could choose to break up several bay leaves and place them in a carrier oil to make an infused oil for communication, a protection bath oil, or a candle oil for love spells. Purple dead nettle. Lamium purpureum grows wild all over North America in poor soil and on the side of the road. This tempestuous weed, remember weed just means a plant that grows where it is not intended to, is valuable for use in spells involving joy and happiness. While it has no smell and is not suited to essential oil production, an infused oil is the perfect use for this herb. Simply dry plant material and add to a carrier oil. Dried plant material is more suited to infused oils, as water content can lead to reduced shelf life or spoiling concerns. For harder, hardier, or woody plant material, look to conditioned oils. Here's a basic recipe for an infused oil. 1. Fill a 4-ounce bottle halfway with carrier oil. 2. Place 2 tablespoons of dried plant material in the bottle and fill the rest of the way with carrier oil. Do not forget to leave room in the headspace for a dropper, if your bottle has one. Placing the herbs in the middle of the bottle makes the mixture easier to stir. 3. Shake the bottle daily for the first week and let it sit for a minimum of 6 weeks before use. Jojoba is a great choice for infused oils, as it is shelf-stable for up to 2 years or more when properly stored. You'll know if it goes rancid. Your nose will alert you. Rancid jojoba smells like burnt gym socks. If this should happen, just throw it away. There is no trick to save it. Dispose of it and get a new fresh supply. Here is a formula for vanilla-infused jojoba that serves as a love or gambling oil. 1. Slice a vanilla bean lengthwise to expose the seeds inside. 2. Now place the 2 halves of the vanilla pod into a bottle containing jojoba oil. 3. Allow this to sit for several weeks. No need to remove the vanilla bean. Looking for an uplifting infused oil to bring happiness? 1. Place a handful of dried orange peel into a clear glass bottle containing the carrier oil of your choice. 2. Let it gently warm in the sun for a day before moving it to a darker spot, such as a kitchen cabinet. 3. Store the oil for 4 to 6 weeks before use. No need to strain out the orange peel. Conditioned oils. Conditioned oils are similar to infused oils, with two key differences: the use of fresh plants and low heat. The application of heat removes excess water from the mixture, so fresh plant material can be used. Conditioned oils may have a stronger fragrance and a bit more energy than their infused counterparts. All that energy goes into your magical working. With the advent of slow cookers and crockpot liners, creating personalized oils is much easier. Have the slow cooker on keep warm or low heat for conditioning oils, even overnight. The key is to keep the mixture at low heat because you don't want to damage the volatile oils in the plant material. Anytime there are plant materials present, make sure the lid is on tightly. After 8 hours or so, turn off the heat and allow the oil to cool. Then bottle. No need to sit before use. Anointing oils. Anointing oils are popularly used for anointing candles, as well as people, ritual statuary, and more. This transforms the object or person into a holy one, denoting reverence. Following are a few basic recipes. All-purpose anointing oil. This oil is beneficial for full moons, religious holidays, and any ritual or special day. 1 drop cedarwood essential oil, Cedrus atlantica, for consecration. 1 drop clove essential oil, Syzygium aromaticum, to dispel negativity. 2 drops frankincense essential oil, for purification. 2 tablespoons carrier oil. Reverence oil. Anoint candles dedicated to the gods in thanks and ritual. 1 drop cinnamon leaf essential oil, Cinnamomum verum, for uplifting. 1 drop ginger essential oil, Zingiber officinale, for healing. 1 drop pine essential oil, Pinus sylvestris, for cleansing. 2 drops sandalwood essential oil, Santalum spicatum, for calming. 2 tablespoons carrier oil. Goddess blessing oil. Anoint pulse points before meditation, prayer, or ritual. 2 drops jasmine absolute, Jasminum officinale, for spiritual love. 1 drop peppermint essential oil, Mentha piperita, for consecration. 3 drops rose absolute, Rosa damascena, for harmony. 2 1/4 tablespoons carrier oil. Room spray. Anytime a synergy recipe mentions water diffusers, it is possible to use a water-based room spray or a hydrosol if a diffuser is impractical. Place a teaspoon of salt, table salt is fine for this application, in a glass bowl and add approximately 30 drops of essential oil or synergy per ounce of water. Stir well. Once the oils are thoroughly blended, transfer the salt into the spray bottle and fill with water warm enough to dissolve the salt. Give it a good shake before spraying. The salt can be substituted with witch hazel from the pharmacy. The essential oils need an intermediary because oil and water do not mix. If essential oils are placed directly into water for spraying, it can leave oil stains on surfaces, so use caution and always use an intermediary. Hydrosols. Since these have a higher water content than their essential oil counterpart, don't expect a hydrosol to smell exactly like the oil. Magical practitioners need not do anything to it, as it has the same magical properties of the essential oil. It is much more affordable. Hydrosols are excellent bases for liquid clearing blends. They are gentle on the skin and can safely be added to the bath when an essential oil may be irritating. Energy cleansing spritz. 1 ounce juniper hydrosol. Juniperus osteosperma for protection. 1 ounce peppermint hydrosol. Mentha peperita for purification. 3 drops sandalwood essential oil. Santalum album for calming. 1 teaspoon salt. To a 2 ounce spray bottle, add a teaspoon table salt and add sandalwood essential oil. Mix well. Add hydrosols, leaving room for spray pump. Shake to mix. Spray anywhere the energy needs a lift. Bath oils. Cost-effective and naturally scented, bath oils are a major player in the list of oil tricks. They can be given as gifts at holidays and put together on the go after a stressful day. Place 5 to 7 drops of essential oil into 1 ounce of carrier oil. This blend will nourish skin and leave you feeling soft and sweet-smelling. If there is a concern about slipping, consider mixing your essential oil into whole milk or powdered milk rather than oil and pour into the bathtub. The milk acts as an emulsifier, allowing the oil to mix with the bathwater. This makes a nice contrast to bath salts, which can have a drying effect on chapped or damaged skin. Bath salts. Bath salts are a quick and easy method of dispersing essential oils into bathwater without the dangers of slipping and falling associated with bath oils. Magically, salt is purifying and beneficial for aching muscles and many other health and well-being challenges. Basic salt scrub. Add 30 drops of the synergy of your choice to 2 cups salt and stir thoroughly. Pour desired amount under warm running bath water. If using a clear glass container for aesthetic purposes, mix small batches that will be used quickly. Store the excess salt mixture in an airtight container, preferably in a dark glass container or in a room without UV light exposure. Note: bath salts can have a drying effect on chapped or damaged skin, so consider using a bath oil in the winter. Sugar scrubs. Sugar scrubs can be enjoyed in the shower, but remember never to add sugar to bathwater. Sugar added to bathwater can feed yeast organisms and lead to an overgrowth, known as an infection. Sugar scrubs versus salt scrubs. Salt and sugar may look similar, but that's where the similarities end. When it comes to the types of skin on the body, the thicker skin, hands, arms, legs, feet, will benefit from a sugar scrub over a salt scrub. The salt scrub will feel softer on the face and will not have the sharp edges that sugar crystals do. On thinner facial skin, the edges of sugar crystals can lead to micro lacerations that can become infected and lead to scarring and premature aging. Basic sugar scrub. 4 tablespoons fractionated coconut oil for a long shelf life. 2 gel caps vitamin E, natural preservative. Optional, 10 drops essential oil. 1 tablespoon honey, 1/2 cup sugar. Grab a wide-mouthed, latch-topped jar. Screw tops are difficult to operate when hands are slippery, and the grit can make getting the lid back on difficult. Make sure the opening is big enough to comfortably accommodate your entire hand. It'll make scooping out the finished product easier. Add the coconut oil to the jar, then pierce each vitamin E gel cap with a pin and squeeze the contents into the oil. Give it a quick stir to combine. If adding scent, add essential oils. Add the honey and stir until incorporated. Add the sugar slowly, stirring until completely blended. Add more coconut oil if needed until the desired consistency is reached. Creating an essential oil blend. While a book of this size can be overwhelming, it should be stated that no one is expected to memorize this much material before experimenting with magical aromatherapy. Each essential oil is structured to encourage a technique called simpling. Pick an essential oil or three and learn its every use. Use the oils chosen for as many uses as possible and really get to know them. Think of this book as a dinner party and each of the oils we're going to discuss as a guest. Having met Petite Grain once, it may be easy to remember that Petite Grain has two sisters, Bitter Orange and Narrowly. However, if a few weeks pass without encountering Petite Grain, the names of her sisters may easily fall from the memory banks. Conversely, an encounter soon after meeting Petite Grain, 3 days later, for instance, will reinforce what you've learned about her. By learning as many uses as possible for each oil chosen before moving on to the next, your memory will retain much more than if you listen to this book straight through and then leave it. Remember, we retain a much higher percentage of what we learn by doing rather than listening and reading. Purchase the oils that smell the best to you. We are all pleasure-driven mammals, after all, and learn everything.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.